We're here today because the Writers Guild is demanding better contract terms from the AMPTP. And what that means is all of your favorite TV shows are not only written by writers, writers are involved with those TV shows at every step along the way. We're there in the very early days of coming up with an idea. We're obviously there while the scripts are written, but really importantly, writers are also on set, making sure that the script is executed properly, pitching jokes on set, making sure that the scripts turn out the way that we envision them. And the changes that have happened in this industry over the last decade have resulted in fewer writers on set, smaller rooms of writers, lower wages for writers, and what was really reliably a middle-class career 15 years ago is now something that feels a lot more like gig work.
Well, we're on strike here in front of the Warner Brothers studio. We're on strike to protect television and film writing as a profession, to make sure that the studios aren't able to turn this into a freelance gig work where, you know, you can't make a living at it anymore. That's what they're trying to do. And we're on strike in order to put in place basic protections that will ensure that this is a job where people can continue to participate in the share of the profits of what their work generates and can continue to live and work in Los Angeles or New York.
We are on strike because the studios are not paying us for the work that we are doing for them.
Guess what she said. Also, we're also having a Westworld writers meetup. Yes. So this is, yeah, we're with some other Westworld writers from season 3 and season 4. So yeah.
We're out here to make sure that human writers continue to write human stories for human beings. And we don't want computers to tell our stories because they can't, because people are being lazy or because they want financial gain. And it's just important that we keep the human side of storytelling human.
I would say that writers are a very important part of the creative process, and studios have made a lot of decisions based on economics that are forcing us out of the roles that are very important. They are hiring us for less time, they are paying us less money, and they are asking us to do more work. And we think that we should be paid comparably for the skills that we're offering, and so we're going on strike for that.
The last strike was really focused on streaming. Streaming was new. We were all getting used to the idea of Netflix, and couldn't even, I think, conceive of where streaming would go between then and now. Obviously, now most of us aren't watching cable. We're not renting DVDs through the mail. We're streaming. The Guild made big advances in 2007-08 to make sure that work was compensated, but as things have continued to change, our contract hasn't kept up, and so we're here to make sure that streaming work is compensated in an appropriate way.
But yeah, I think it's become sort of harder and harder to sustainably work, and it's always been an industry where you work for a period and then have breaks, but some of the things that allow that to be sustainable, like residuals from shows with the new streaming models and people not being compensated for working on hit shows like they would be if you worked on Friends. Like, you're probably still doing pretty great off that. But so I think a lot of the things that allow it to be a sustainable lifestyle and career for people are being taken away. So we're fighting for those things.
I mean, look, AI cannot do the work of a writer, right? AI, the large language models that exist can output text, but writing is a lot more than outputting text. Writing is working with other people, talking to those people, the directors, actors, the executives, knowing what's expensive, what is cheap to shoot, talking to the line producer to economize, you know, make sure the budget is economical enough for the script. It's a deeply collaborative art form, and until AI is literally as good as Data from Star Trek, right, it can't do the work of a writer. They're always going to need writers. The concern is that companies are going to use these algorithms to erode the working conditions of writers, to say, oh, the AI wrote a script, and now we just need you to punch it up. We need you to talk to the director, talk to the actors, make sure it's within budget, go to set to, you know, give any line tweaks that are needed. Oh, but you're not the writer. The AI is the writer. We're going to pay you a fraction of what you used to make to do all that work. We're concerned about those sort of erosions, and we're not going to let them do it. One of the reasons we're on strike is to put in place basic protections against so-called AI being used to hurt writers and our livelihoods.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it's an interesting issue because it's still obviously developing. I mean, one aspect I find interesting about it, too, is that what AI is doing is it's taking work from human writers or creators and like using that. So like how do those creators get compensated for the fact that AI is basically just like regenerating their work? But yeah, I'm glad the Guild is sort of like addressing it now at the early stages. I'm not sure where it's going to go or how quickly it's going to develop to a level where, you know, AI could write a Breaking Bad. But I'm a little skeptical about that. But I think it will start to be used as a tool to cut out writers out of the process and hire fewer writers. So
the biggest challenge with AI is that I would like not to use it. And so that's why I'm here to defend human jobs and working with and for people and learning with and learning with other people. I think there is an idea from the studios that as more and more of what we watch is determined by algorithms, they'd like to take that the natural next step and have the algorithms just write the shows. I don't think that is going to make for good shows, and I don't want to work that way. So I'm just here for humans.
Listen, our world is scary and nothing is promised. And if you let percentages decide what you want to do with your life, you're never going to win. Don't pay attention to percentages. Don't pay attention to what's happening in the world. Live your life and then let your talent and the world decide what happens from there. But we're already defeated if we don't do the things we want to do because we're afraid or it looks daunting. I would still be in Cleveland, Ohio. I wouldn't be an actor if I paid attention to even some of my closest friends and family members. Oh, it's so hard, you'll never make a living, and I'm here. So you can't pay attention to numbers and things that happen. You have to follow your dream, because a lot of times you don't get to decide who says no or yes, but you have to know that you tried.
I mean, look, I think what this strike shows you is that the writing community in Los Angeles and New York and everywhere is a really strong, motivated, passionate group. We are here for each other. We are doing this even though it's hard. We are doing this for the writers that are going to come after us, because we want people to be able to have careers in this community. We want people to be able to make a living doing the things that they love. You should be able to love what you do and get paid for it. And we're out here to show that people coming after us can do that as well.
So we're here not just for our jobs, but really for the next generation of writers, making sure that this industry stays as important and fulfilling and, you know, not just important to us, but important to the country and the culture. We make art that people really watch, and we want to keep doing a good job. So that's why we're here.
I mean, look, the people have been scared about the industry for many times over the past century. The Writers Guild has existed for 90 years. The only reason that writing has ever been a sustainable profession, or directing or acting, is because we have strong unions in this town that have shown willingness to use member power in order to achieve the gains that we need. The only reason I have health insurance or health care is because writers of the past went on strike for that for me. And so now it's my turn to go on strike for other folks in the future and for my own future. The industry is not in a great state right now. But unions, meaning the workers who actually create the product, working together, have the power to fix the industry. We've done it in the past, and we're doing it again, and this is our moment. So I would say, don't feel disheartened. Feel enormously optimistic that this is what average people working together are able to achieve.
We're out here for people who want to get into this industry. We're out here to ensure that there is an industry for you to get into in 10 years. I will say this is the most fun job I've ever had. I love my job. I love every day that I am at work making jokes with my friends. I would much rather be doing that than getting honked at and yelling at people to get out of the crosswalks, but here we are. But if this is your dream, then pursue it. It's so satisfying. It's a great job.
I feel like if you can show up at some of the rallies, if you live in California or New York, it's always great if you could donate water or snacks, even just blowing your horn. I know the city probably discourages that, but just blowing your horn and letting people know, hey, we're with you. You write and tell some of the stories that we watch and love. They're really a part of history. And if you think about growing up, the shows that you watch, I know they shaped me. I'm wearing a Superman shirt because somebody wrote about a super guy from another planet that has superpowers. So I just feel like if you can blow your horn or show up, bring water, snacks, whatever it is, be nice to them and pray for us, I guess that'd be the last thing. But that's what I would say.
generation through the workers' blood shall run. There can be no power greater anywhere beneath the sun. Yet what force on earth is weaker than the feeble strength of one? But the Union makes us.